Hi guys. In a previous video, which I'll link down below, we talked about the non-directional beacon, or NDB, as a navigation tool used by pilots around the world. Tonight we're going to talk about ground-based navigation system called the VOR. VOR stands for VHF Omnidirectional Radio Range. We'll discuss how these systems work and how pilots use them to navigate. So here we go. The VOR ground station operates in the 108 to 118 megahertz radio frequency band. This band lies directly above the FM broadcast band and immediately below the aviation voice frequencies. You can tell a VOR transmitter when you see one, as they have very distinctive looking antenna, like these ones here. When we talked about NDBs, we said they were non-directional. That is, they transmit in all directions at the same time. The receiver senses the direction of the transmitter by the difference in signal levels in the two antennas on board the aircraft. VORs work entirely differently, as shown by this animated diagram. The ground station broadcasts an all-round radio signal and broadcasts signals sequentially, clockwise, through a series of very directional antennas. It's these antennas you can see on top of the VOR. The transmitter cycles through all directions about 30 times per second. Equipment on the aircraft listens for the phase difference between the two signals to determine which direction it is sitting. The line of direction from the transmitter to the aircraft is known as the radial. In this example, the aircraft is sitting on the 105 radial. In other words, it is sitting on a line 105 degrees magnetic from the VOR. If the aircraft was due south of the transmitter, it would be on the 180 radial. The name of the radial is always referred to as the direction from the ground station, no matter which way the aircraft is flying. We mentioned that with NDBs, pilots identify that they are listening to the correct ground station by checking the Morse code identifier modulated onto the transmission. Also, that some NDBs are also used to transmit weather and operational information from the local airport. Well, the same goes for the VOR. So when a pilot is preparing to navigate in relation to a VOR, they will tune its frequency in via the radio panel and then listen to ensure they can hear the Morse identifier. The aircraft cockpit gauge, called an omni-bearing indicator, consists of a compass rose, a vertical needle, called a course deviation indicator, a to-from flag, which is shown as a triangle in this example, and an adjustment knob, which is down here. The knob is used to select the radial which you are attempting to navigate in relation to. The needle sweeps from left to right depending on which side of the radial you're located. The aircraft is positioned in the middle of the gauge, so in this case the radial is to the left of the aircraft. When the aircraft is located on the selected radial, the needle is centered. The dots here indicate 2-degree intervals from the aircraft's location, both left and right of the aircraft. On this real-world gauge, there is also a horizontal needle, which is used for aligning with the glide slope in an instrument landing system. We won't be discussing that today, but might save that for another video. Before I take you into the simulator to show you how to navigate using the VOR, there's another ground-based system which is often located with the VOR, which I should mention. The other system is called a DME, which stands for Distance Measuring Equipment. I'm not going to go into detail about DMEs today, other than to understand that it measures the straight line distance from the aircraft to the ground station and displays it to the pilot. So in this case, the DME is 4.1 nautical miles. So let's go to the simulator. Today we're flying around Cairns in far northeastern Australia. In this aircraft, the omni-bearing indicator is located here. The yellow arrow here indicates the radial in which you want to align with. In this case, it's due west, 270. The smaller yellow arrow here is used by the autopilot to hold the aircraft on the heading of the pointer. The to from flag is here and is pointing up, which means you are heading towards the transmitter. So at the moment we're flying on a heading of 245 degrees. We're aiming to fly in on a heading of 270 towards the VOR, and that's inbound on the 090 radial. Here's another way to look at the situation. So at the moment we're flying on a heading of 240 degrees, we're aiming to fly in on a heading of 270 towards the VOR, that is, we're going to be flying in on the 090 degree radial. So the needle is pointing 2.5 dots to the left of the aircraft, meaning that the selected radial is 5 degrees to the left of the aircraft, or that the aircraft is 5 degrees to the right of the selected radial. Over here is the distance from the ground station as measured by the distance measuring equipment. It's displaying 12 nautical miles. We're tracking to intercept and fly along the 090 radial. As we approach the radial, you'll see the needle move towards the centre of the gauge, and once we're over the centre, we're right on it. We'll start turning onto our desired heading of 270. And there we come around to 270 aligned with the 090 radial. As we approach the VOR at 2 nautical miles out, you'll notice that the needle becomes unsteady and it becomes harder to remain exactly on the 090 radial. This is because as we get closer to the VOR, all of the radials get closer together, and it only takes a small movement to find yourself on another radial. You can see on this diagram of radials where the red dot is quite a distance away from the next radial on either side, but it's much closer to the next radial as it moves closer to the centre. As we approach over the top of the VOR, the to from flag disappears and the word nav appears. This is an error flag indicating that it can't determine whether the heading is to or from the VOR. As we continue, however, the flag will show that we're heading away from the VOR, and the DME will start to increase again. In a similar way to the NDB approach we discussed in a previous video, the pilot can fly a VOR approach. This is a procedure where the pilot aligns the aircraft with the runway without having to see the runway or have any visual references until just prior to landing. This type of approach allows the pilot to fly a known set of directions and altitudes which are free of mountains and other obstructions. The pilot can make several different approaches here. One is a circling approach with a procedure term a bit similar to the NDB approach we discussed previously, which is this one here. So we can enter this approach in several ways, but today we're going to overfly it from the south. We're going to head out on this 012 degree radial until we reach 8 DME from Cairns. Then we'll make a left turn and align inbound with a 360 degree radial on a heading of 180. In terms of altitude, we'll overfly the VOR at 5,000 feet and descend to 2,000 feet, not reaching 2,000 until we've finished the turn. We'll then descend to 1,500 feet until 5 DME, and then 730 feet until we reach the missed approach point, where we'll decide we can see the runway to land, or we'll apply power and follow the missed approach procedure, climbing to 4,000 feet. So let's have a look at the simulator. Here we're about 4 DME to the south of the VOR. We're tracking inbound on the 146 radial. a heading of 326 degrees. As we approach the VOR, the needle becomes unsteady, and the nav warning flag comes on to indicate that we can't use it for navigation. The DME shows we're pretty much over the top of the VOR, so we turn onto our outbound heading of 012 degrees and set up our gauge onto 012 radial and start our descent to 2,000 feet. You'll notice that the 2 from flag is pointing down, indicating the VOR is behind us. We then adjust our heading to keep on the 012 radial until we reach 8 DME. At 8 DME, we make that left turn and adjust our gauge to 180 degrees as we'll be heading inbound on the 360 degree radial. You can see that I'm steering a little to the west of 180 degrees to bring me back onto the radial. You'll also notice that the 2 from flag is now pointing to the VOR. As we approach the radial, we can turn onto a heading of 180 degrees to bring us onto final for landing. So that's a bit of a guide on how VORs work. I hope it was of interest to you and that you learned something from it. Of course, all the usual YouTube stuff, that if you like the video, give it thumbs up or leave a comment below. And if there's anything else you want to see, please leave me a comment and I'll see what I can do. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.